because no matter what you pass, somebody's going to come up with something else. The real key issue here is that we the people are the government, and we the people have to be active on an ongoing basis. And I still think, just like a lot of the rest of us have been in the past, just sitting home watching TV and live and let live and not getting involved as much as I should have until things got this bad. That's how they got this bad. So now we have a lot of makeup work to do till we get back to where it's easy. Point here is, this is a lifelong commitment. Sometimes it will be hard, like now. Sometimes it will be easy. But it's an ongoing thing at local, the state, and the federal level. We need to stay involved. We need to know what's going on. We need to voice our opinion. If you give up your rights, they're gone. If you want to maintain your rights, you have to exercise them.
And we need to pass it on to the next generation.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Textbooks are next.
Not your homeschool.
I think ultimately, if you want to stop everything that they're doing, we have to build to a movement to repeal that 16th Amendment.
There you go, sir.
And leave it in the hands of the states, the power to fund the federal government. So if the federal government's no longer doing what we want them to do, they no longer have the power to come after the individual citizen. But the states say, you're not behaving in the interest of our sovereignty, we won't fund you.
We know actually it's the job of the states to put the federal government in check.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah.
And that's where it's been remiss. But we've been remiss as citizens because we've allowed them to do it. So now that we are there and we're not going anywhere, we have to let our local, our state legislators know that. And I have a feeling they're not going to know what hit them on January 18th. I'm so excited I can't tell you. I get on the phone every now and then with Jamie, and she and I go back and get each other fired up, and we rally one another. But we're pretty excited about this. I can't thank you all enough for coming out here tonight. What a great turnout. But I want to go over, yes, I'll take your other questions.
Just to kind of expand on some of the comments that have been made about our involvement. What we're doing as a group, it's going to involve more than that, because somewhere along the line, individuals are going to have to start stepping up to the plate to run for these offices.
Absolutely.
Because we keep saying get the bums out, somebody's got to be there to take their place.
What are you doing, Rob?
That's got to happen. So it's going to involve more than just a group effort. We got to get individuals say, okay, you're going out and I'm going
to eat. Well, let me know when you get your website out. Yes, sir.
Hey, one guy that young lady mentioned about the 16th Amendment. See, this is something else. Jefferson said about if you expect to be ignorant and free, you expect what never was and never will be. Well, see, the 16th Amendment isn't what you think it is. What you need to do is take a look. How many here has read the IRS code?
Actually, several volumes back to 1924.
Okay. Like see, the part about it is there is no authority. Well, let me ask you a question. How many here think they're taxing your income? You think you're taxing your income? You know, your income? Isn't that what you think that's what they're taxing? They say, but, see, this is the forest right there, we can't see it. They say federal income tax. How many here have gotten federal income?
I don't live on federal land.
Did anybody here? Federal income tax. The name's right. It's all right there.
Constitution to tax labor wages.
No, see, the Constitution, the founding fathers are pretty smart. The fact of the matter is, we as individuals, you're able to be co-op, just like if you had your own property. You got a big farm, you can raise your crops. The government doesn't have any authority to come in and take a third of it, right? Which is, in essence, would be tax, right? If you are self-sufficient, right? All we're doing when we work for each other is we're doing the same thing. You understand? We're still working for income to pay for our sustenance, right? if you want to take and get a book to look at this, your blood pressure's going to go up a little bit. But the fact of the matter is, the IRS code, if when you think about an employee, you think it's working for somebody, don't you? According to the IRS code, it's specific. And when in a code section they put a specific meaning to a word, it loses its general meaning, okay? In other words, if they say it only means this in that code section, that's all it can mean throughout that whole code, okay? So, see, what they tax is they tax the activity. That's what's being taxed. Not the income, the activity. The income that is earned is the measurement of the tax. But if you're not engaged in a taxable activity, which is specified in the IRS code, then guess you what? You're not an official taxpayer. And if you read on this, and it's all there for you to read, they call it voluntary. Okay? And the bottom line is, you know how you get in there? By signing on the bottom line saying that you belong in it. And do you think they're going to tell you you don't? No. This is the ironic thing. There's actually in the code section, if somebody takes out withholding from any of you people, there's a federal law that it's a criminal offense if they're taking withholding from you and then they don't belong under the IRS code. She has to protect the citizen. There's a federal law that does that. So all they're saying is, this is a case of our lack of knowledge. I started paying taxes like that at the age of 14 because guess what? Everybody else was. That's it. I didn't read 3,400,000, however many thousand words it is. But since the internet, there have been men doing more studies, thank God for those people. You know, thank you for being here. In other words, it takes this citizenry to be informed. Peter Hendrickson wrote the book, Cracking the Code. You really want to find out about the IRS, what a sham this has been, and how they are taken. And this thing, we can stop this in a heartbeat, stop the blood supply, because quite frankly, most of you, I'll guarantee 95% of you, or probably 99% of you, wouldn't even fall under the IRS code as indicated by the IRS code itself.
What's his name again?
But there,
Peter Hendricks.
There have been some challenges to that law, however, and people have still gone to jail.
Yeah, I want to mention this to you. See, the part about it is there are people have gone to jail fighting this thing, but what happened is, you don't go to them saying you're going to refuse to pay income tax, okay? When you talk to the federal government, you ask them, okay, you put the burden of proof on them, please, I want to get this clarified, you say I owe this tax, please clarify this and show me the taxable activity I was engaged in. You see what I mean? It's not that you're trying to avoid taxes, you understand? But you can go out and read it. I can't tell you what to do. Go read the book. These people have got their money back. There have been people that have been, they were getting penalties, interest, all this other kind of stuff. The IRS was coming after them, scaring people, intimidating people, and they got their money back. And of course, they use these people that didn't understand. See, the attorneys don't understand. That's how people went to jail.
Well, you know, the same thing if happened with driver's license.
Yes. Yes.
Amen.
So, in other words, we need to be
legally
learned ourselves. We need to study.
You have the right to drive. We're not required under the Constitution to have a driver's license to drive.
Commercial service.
Under the Constitution, we're allowed to have to travel the roads, the highways. It's your right. It's your natural right.
Everybody stands up and does the same.
But you become a victim
of the bureaucracy
when you sign on to get a driver's license. Once you get a permit,